The COVID-19 pandemic has opened an open door for reevaluating the manner in which nations plan for general well-being emergencies. This window should not be squandered. A year has passed by since the World Health Organization announced the COVID-19 pandemic a worldwide pandemic on the 11th of March 2020. Almost 100 million individuals have become debilitated around the world, in excess of 2 million have kicked the bucket, and numerous survivors are encountering long-stretch manifestations. Notwithstanding progresses in the inoculation and clinical the executives of patients with COVID-19, the finish of the most noticeably awful general well-being emergency in a century isn't almost in sight yet. In this issue, we dispatch an exceptional focus devoted to understanding the drawn-out effect of the COVID-19 pandemic and to start to investigate the exercises that can be gained from the missteps made in dealing with the current well-being emergency, to plan for future emergencies. Throughout setting up this uncommon issue of nature medicine, we connected with numerous specialists who have been associated with the reaction to the COVID-19 pandemic, counting scientists who have contributed original examination that permitted comprehension of the science of SARS-CoV-2, the host-resistant reaction to the infection and how COVID-19 shows clinically, to test the adequacy of helpful approaches and to create antibodies. We likewise talked with disease transmission specialists, general well-being specialists, policymakers, and analysts whose work centers around the flexibility of well-being frameworks, administration and the execution of well-being strategies. From these discussions, caught in pieces distributed in this issue and others that will show up over time in our pages, a couple of normal topics arose. From one perspective, there is a feeling of logical achievement, and that the worldwide research local area has altogether adapted to the situation forced by the pandemic. In no other time throughout the entire existence of science has such a lot of data been created, shared and conveyed so rapidly to deliver a danger to humankind. On the other hand is the acknowledgement that no measure of exploration and logical turn of events can make up for ineffectual initiative and an absence of coordination inside governments and global participation between nations. More than anything else, the COVID-19 emergency has been a disappointment for the administration. There is an unmistakable sense that planning for the following pandemic will require a profound plunge into those disappointments, understanding what turned out badly and running after improving the design of well-being security administration, a point made by John Nkengasong. Conquering institutional lack of concern is likewise basic to the improvement of a long-haul pandemic readiness methodology that is driven by logical proof and training of the populace and that makes progress toward well-being security, as contended by previous World Health Organization Director General Margaret Chan. It is a shocking exercise of the COVID-19 pandemic that its loss of life is enhanced by heap fundamental normal medical issue that are progressively more predominant in the general populace, like diabetes, weight and hypertension. Expanding the strength of well-being frameworks through widespread medical care arrangements can improve the general well-being of populaces and may diminish the weight of fatalities in future flare-ups. Accomplishing widespread medical care isn't without its difficulties, however it is conceivable, and Ole Norheim and partners draw a guide of how bundles of fundamental well-being administrations can be created in asset-obliged settings, drawing on their experience growing such bundles in Ethiopia. Paul Spiegel further portrays the difficulties of reacting to a pandemic in philanthropic settings, and Devi Sridhar and partners summarize the present status of undertakings in worldwide well-being administration in this first year of the pandemic, with an eye on exercises for what's to come. Madhukar Pai and partners tackle a regularly neglected point that has demonstrated to be a significant bottleneck in the general well-being reaction during the current pandemic, the issue of restricted analytic testing limit, and the need to assemble a superior structure for testing as a feature of pandemic readiness methodologies. Administration disappointment has additionally showed through a multiplication of deception, what's more, doubt in science and well-being experts and a resulting absence of consistency with general well-being estimates that can save lives and diminish a pandemic. Elizabeth Higgs and Associates present an outline of good practices that upgrade public commitment in research and with medication during a continuous general well-being emergency. Imran Ahmed talks about the difficulties of managing an expanding protection from inoculation and the need to comprehend what is behind the falsehood industry. The significance of obtaining dependable data during a continuous general well-being emergency and how such information can be utilized to take care of and fabricate models to help in the comprehension of key pathogenic, epidemiologic, clinical and socio-conduct attributes of a continuous episode are shrouded in a point of view by Joseph Wu and partners. Discussing foreseeing future dangers, Mike May talked with a few irresistible infection specialists about what tomorrow's greatest microbial dangers could be. Also, Ralph Barrick and Rita Megink present an outline of the medication improvement pipeline for new irresistible specialists, and the need for new vision, devoted subsidizing and private, government and scholastic association models. At long last, considering what the pandemic has meant for our local area of scientists, clinicians and well-being experts, we have requested that our perusers share with us how they have utilized craftsmanship to record their encounters through the previous year and to adapt with the vulnerabilities forced by the pandemic. We got some more entries on Twitter than we might feature in a solitary issue, and a choice picked by the Nature Medicine Group is introduced in a unique element and on the front of this issue of the diary. The world is still practically amidst an emergency, and one may contend that it is too soon to begin talking of getting ready for future pandemics. We deviate, we think that presently is the correct opportunity to discuss the future and about the progressions that need to end up improving the worldwide ability to react to well-being emergencies of this extent. Experience from the new past has more than once shown that assets, subsidizing and political capital will in general tighten as an episode does. The genuine effect of COVID-19, be that as it may, in both well-being terms and financial terms, is probably going to outlive the term of the intense period of the pandemic, opening a window of opportunity for enduring change while the virus is still on people's minds. This window of opportunity must not be wasted.